I'm going to do a prone PCNL on a patient aged 59 years old. Patient is asthmatic, so we are doing this case in spinal anesthesia. I'd like to show the glimpse of the IVP first. There is no CT being done. It's a obese patient. On the plain film, we are able to see that there is a stone from the pelvis. It's going towards the lower pole, I guess. And there is another stone. Mostly that stone is in the middle calyx. It's a small stone. There are two stones, one extending from the pelvis towards the inferior pole, and another one, hopefully it's in the middle calyx. This is a 5-minute film. Are you able to see, sir? Are you able to appreciate?
Yeah, Harsha, carry on. We are able to see.
So this is the 5 minutes supine film. This is the 10-minute supine film. Over here you can see the posterior calyces getting opposite well, and the lower pole also faintly getting opposite. So there is a stone in the middle pole and the extension from the pelvis towards the lower pole, sir.
Harsha, which calyx you want to puncture? What you have decided?
Sir, mostly I am expecting a blotch in the inferior calyx, sir. So at the point I would like to puncture the inferior calyx so that I could clear the pelvic stone which is approaching the inferior infundibulum. After clearance of that, we'll try to see that if the middle calyx stone is approachable from the same side. I would like to show my table here. The trolley here, it's a very simplified trolley, no fancy instruments. What we do daily, that's it I'm going to show. Only a 24 sheath amplax is there, a Sahaj suction sheath is there, which comes with an integrated obturator here. And I have also kept a mini scope of stores, 12 French ready. So if I want to take a separate middle calyceal puncture, I will be doing with this.
Right.
So, yeah, so the PCNL is all about anticipation. You have to anticipate everything, all the entry strategies should be clear. I've attached a 19.5 French, I've kept my scope with white balance and everything ready, because once you are in the system, every surgeon is in a panicky mode. He is apprehended to go into the system, see where the stone is. So that time lag, I want to just cut down, and everything is kept ready on my operation table. And there is a two-part needle I am going to puncture with. So I would like to focus on the C-arm now. Shoot. So here you can see nicely, shoot, continue shoot, sir, please. So you can see that there is a stone approaching the from the pelvis towards the inferior pole, and there is another stone in the middle calyx. In this C-arm, there is a little bit lag. I will like to show the lag also. Shoot, shoot. So when we move our needle, see there is reflections of the needle seen. So this is the lag. A lag is not very much liked by a surgeon, but anyways, we'll continue now. Wait. So once I have clicked a plain image on the CM, I will always like to save that image on the other screen, because it is the first thing that after the clearance of the stone, if you want to compare your previous image, there should be a saved image on the other screen. So I have saved my image on the other screen. So I will like to do an RGP now. So while doing RGP, wait, I will like to first shoot, continue shooting on, yeah, now inject. So slowly injection has been done of the contrast. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Right. So my plan of puncture will be the inferior calyx. Most probably I could approach the middle calyx. Once the inferior calyx dilatation is done, we'll see for the middle calyceal stone. I'm doing my puncture in a complete monoplanar technique. It's a 0-degree technique, no touch technique to the C-arm. I won't be touching the C-arm in this case, hopefully. If it gets difficult, then I will go for a bullseye also. Let's see. Shoot. So I am orienting my needle almost 45 degrees to the skin surface, to the sagittal plane. Shoot. Yeah. Shoot, shoot, shoot. So a 2 to 3 centimeter distance from the desired calyx, I am marking my skin surface entry point. So this is the entry point. Stab knife, please. have taken a scab knife puncture. I'm orienting my needle so that I could hit my posterior calyx, posterior aspect of the lower pole. So I'm going in, I will just feel my kidney with some jerky movement so that when the kidney stops, see the kidney has stopped in the respiration, it is not moving well. Are you able to appreciate, sir?
Yeah.
Yes. So now this is the point. From this I will just slide my needle ahead so that I will be entering the posterior aspect of the inferior pole. The posterior aspect is not seen. What you are seeing on the screen is the anterior calyx. But you have to imagine in a 3D anatomy that the posterior calyx is almost 90 degrees towards the what the calyx is shown on the Siam, because Siam image is a 2D image. I will just slide in. So I will just enter gently, flush from below. Flush, normal saline. So I'll attach your 2cc needle here. I'll ask my assistant to flush, shoot. Yes, so in the very first go, you can see that the water has been coming from the puncture side. Are you able to appreciate, sir?
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. So this is a complete 0-degree monoplanar technique, and I would like to show, once I enter the system, I will be showing the anterior calyx. It will be exactly below from the point where I have entered the kidney. I will be placing a Terimo wire here. Shoot. Hopefully it goes into the ureter. Shoot. Okay, it has walked into the superior calyx, but I will try to maneuver this wire in the ureter. See, I have just tilted my needle so that it should walk into the ureter.
Good, very good. Anybody in the audience have questions, they can ask. The mics are there.
So the theory behind putting a wire into a ureter is my all directional forces, my dilatation forces will be directed towards the PUJ and not, it won't hit the opposite wall of the pelvis. Now I am not having a Cobra catheter, but many times I use a Cobra which walks into the ureter, takes the shape of the pelvis, enters the ureter. So your dilatation forces are not acting on the opposite wall. So risk of perforation is minimized with this technique. So I just increase my site of incision. See, my plan is to do a standard PCNL in this case. This is the thing what we do in our day-to-day practice. The patient is in spinal anesthesia. Many of us are doing PCNLs in spinal anesthesia. We are not using lasers in day-to-day practice. So I would like to show a litho break it with a standard PCNL technique of 24 French. Now I am doing a screw dilatation of 14 French. Shoot. See, while doing screw dilatation, you have to remember your path of puncture. Because if there is a step in the dilatation, there will be false passage. There should be no kink in the wire. See, my wire is straightly going in. Shoot. It is gently, I am just screwing it. See my movements, show my hand movements. I am just screwing it. Shoot. So that's it. I will stop here. I won't go further. Guide rod, please.
Can I discuss?
Irrigation chalu roko niche, sir.
I like to discuss one issue.
Yes, sir.
The anesthesia. Because yes, I don't think so this point has been highlighted here anymore. The spinal versus the general anesthesia. So what are the criteria when you select spinal or when you like to do under GA?
Definitely. Sir, 99% of my cases are done in spinal anesthesia. I like spinal so much. The sole reason behind it is if the system, now this system is well below the 11th rib, 12th rib. But when it's a supracostal system we want to puncture, you can just ask your patient to cooperate with you with a deep inspiration so that the kidney comes down well below the rib and there is no apprehension in puncturing those systems. Because in apnea also, that won't be the level when the anesthetist gives an apnea in the general anesthesia, the system won't come down that much when you ask the patient to hold the breath by himself. Sure.
Any other advantage of a spinal?
The anesthetist is answering the question, sir, that the BP is kept low, sir, so that everything is okay. So I have put my guide rod here, sir. I am just touching the stone. Are you able to appreciate, sir?
Yeah.
Just see, I'm thoda piche le lo, bhaiya. Thoda upar le lo, bas. That's it. Fine. So I am dilating with a single strip dilator of 24 French Cook dilator I am using. Over that, I will be using Shah suction shape for 24 French.
Arsha, yes, this is Dr. Sanjay from Nepal.
Yes, sir. Sure.
As you mentioned that, your anesthesia is about 99% under spinal anesthesia.
Yes, sir.
What about the pediatric group?
Yeah, the pediatric group, sir, definitely GA is more preferable.
Obvious, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, I would like to show one point here on the CM, please. You can see how we check that whether we are out of the system or in the system. This is a small trick I would like to show. I will just shoot. I will just forward my guide rod. If the guide rod moves freely in the system along the glide wire, should see, sir, my guide rod is moving freely in the system. So this is a point that everybody should know, that when this movement is appreciated, you are 99% you are in the system and not out of the system. Should. Yeah. आप इरिगेट करते रहो सर.
नाइस पंक्चर. व्हेन यू आर डूइंग डायलेटेशन सिंगल स्टेप, डू यू लाइक टू इंजेक्ट लिटिल बिट ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्ट व्हेन द मैक्सिमम डायलेटर इज एंटरिंग, सो दैट यू विल हैव बेटर ओरिएंटेशन व्हाइल यू आर डायलेटिंग. You will not go ahead. I agree with your point, Alcanrod moving freely. Same yes, time, sir. Can you inject some contrast to dilate the infundibulum, to delineate the infundibulum?
Definitely, sir. That's a very good idea to confirm that whether we are in the desired calyx, we are not going ahead. But what happens, sir, many times there will be an extravasation. So that extravasation will hamper the CM view again. So I won't prefer of injecting a contrast. Once the roadmap is clear in your mind, because you have to fit your RGP in the mind when you are approaching, when you are doing an ECNL.
Yeah. Harsha.
Yes, sir.
Rajesh here. Now,
yes, sir.
There are two things. One, you told that the Elkin rod should move very freely to confirm,
yes,
your access. The similar thing has been described. There is a it's a publication on by Dr. Vasudev Ridorkar, the guide wire friction test. So if your wire moves very smoothly in and out, that is much easier way of doing it, and it is officially known as now as a friction test, and we all use it, and that should be very free movement. That is one. Second, when your assistant is continuously flushing saline from below, that saline should come out from the distal end of your whatever dilator or shield.
Yes, sir. Sir, focus here. Sir, see, he is flushing the saline and it is clearly coming out, sir.
Yeah, we can see that. Just yes, making the point.
So now I am using an Shah's 24 French sheet here, sir. I will just slide that sheet with the rotating movements. The difference between an Amplas dilator and a Shah sheet is, it's a metallic sheet. The Amplas is made of plastic. So here you don't have a grip here to slide your sheet down by the rotating movements. So what I use is, I hold it at the distal end of the sheet so that it easily gets slide in the system. Sure.
Just one question I wanted to ask was, while he's puncturing here,
the
question is that once he was puncturing, his hand is coming in the fluoro, and if he is doing a lot of PCNLs, so what are the precautions he's taking for that?
Sir, I take the care. Very nice question, sir. This is just for demonstration. I am not concentrating on my hand right now, sir.
Not now, otherwise your hand is getting exposed routinely also. What do you...
No way, sir.
How do you avoid that?
Wait. So just a moment. Shoot. After you're sliding a little more.
Harsha, when you are putting your ampulla sheet, it's always a good idea to have a little contrast from below.
Yes, sir, definitely.
Yeah, so that you know exactly where your ampulla sheet is. It's more precise. I don't think it's much extra visit with your guide wire in the ureter. It's always give a comfortable feeling that you are absolutely on the stone.
Yes, sir. Chalo, end of view.
Yeah, now we can see.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Good picture. Beautiful.
Okay, sir. I am showing the infundibulum here. This is the lower pole infundibulum. As I told, sir, that this is the anterior calyx.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And this is how, if we enter from the posterior aspect of the calyx, you can roam around the kidney. Sir, I am able to see the middle calyceal stone also.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Okay. So it's just a matter of time now that I will just break the stone and I will be showing the suction effect of the Shah sheath also for this stone, sir. Now at this point, as I have a very experienced assistant with me, he is assisting me since 6 years. Dr. Gore is there with me, who belongs to Ahmednagar, the same place. We work together. So in this situation now, I am happy that I will be removing my glide wire here, because for the suction to act, there should be no glide wire inside. So now we are safely placed in the system. I will remove my glide wire from this point of time. So PCNL is not just yourself learning. I will like to tell a thing for all the juniors sitting in the hall, that you have to train a team. It's not a single man game. You have to have a team of OT staff. They should know what PCNL is in and out, right from your positioning, making the patient prone, adjusting everything, adjusting your C-arm. They should be trained enough in your C-arm also. So just don't learn PCNL by yourself. You have to train a team. It's a team game. So now I am using a litho. I will start with a litho. I will just show for 5 minutes litho, 5 minutes lasing again from the TFL IPG. I will be using the fragmentation mode. But now I will start the case with using a litho class.
Repeat something about the nephroscope he is using.
So I am using a 19.5 French Stores nephroscope with a working channel of 12.4 French. So care should be taken in such stone. It's a hard stone. You should not perforate the opposite wall of the pelvis. So you have to use litho like a laser. Just place the litho on the stone. Don't push it on the stone. Don't have a firm hand. Keep it with a very loose hand. It will break the stone. If you try to push the stone with the laser and then break with the help of the opposite wall, it is going to perforate the pelvic wall. It's a hard stone, sir. Okay, fine.
While you are breaking the stone, can we talk to your anesthetist about general and spinal anesthesia? What is his comment?
Definitely, sir. Definitely. Anesthetist, sir. Mic. Audio-visual team, please give a mic. Aajao, sir. Practically, there is, in such cases with such a good view inside, lasing in this stone is not practical. For general use, for day-to-day practice, I would just make sizable fragments, you remove them with the forceps and finish the case as soon as possible. But as it is a conference, I would like to show the fragmentation mode of IPG laser also. See how beautifully the litho has broken the stone. It's all sizable stone fragments which will easily come out of a 24 French sheet.
Hello everybody.
Yes.
I am Dr. N.K. Sharma. I am the anesthetist in this case.
Dr. Sharma, welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Tell us, how do you select which case to go for GA or spinal?
Let me tell you that we love those surgeons who do PCNL in spinal anesthesia.
Sorry?
We love those surgeons who do their PCNL in spinal anesthesia.
Okay.
The difference between spinal and GA, I can say that when we put the patient on prone position, in general anesthesia, we have to take a lot of care about the pressure points, abdominal pressure, eye pressure. Because if you are not careful, then there are chances of complications, nerve compressions. So a lot of precautions has to be taken as per. You could have, gel supports for the pressure points and all. If patient is under spinal anesthesia, then he himself can, move his hand. पेरेंट्स इज देयर इज अ प्रेशर ऑन द एल्डर
ओपन नहीं हो रहा है
और
नहीं फोर्स से अच्छा नहीं है
बॉल ही कैन टर्न हिज हेड हियर ऑन बोथ दी
साइड
सो एंड इट्स इजीियर टू पुट द पेशेंट टू प्रोन पोजीशन इफ पेशेंट इज अंडर स्पाइनल फीचर पेशेंट
हिमसेल्फ हेल्प्स
इट टर्निंग इन टर्निंग इट ओ टर्निंग इट In spinal ischia, the other advantage is that the pulse rate and blood pressure, they both are controlled. I mean the pulse rate.
So we have just completed the case, sir. Actually, I waited to show the suction effect of the shaft sheath. Beautiful it was. Almost fragments measuring 5 to 8 mm were easily sucked by the shaft sheath. I will just like to show the anatomy now. I placed a DJ stand here. There was a stone in the middle calyx which we have seen earlier. I have cleared that stone. It was a pickup stone. Secondly, this is the superior calyx entry, sir. And I would like to show a smuggler's pouch in the kidney. The smuggler's pouch is for the juniors. I will name it as a smuggler's pouch because it is that region where you forget to inspect the system once you have completed the case. It is your the place behind your ampulla sheath. So this is the point where many stones get impacted behind the sheath, and you just remove the sheath in hurry up. So wait, inspect the system once you have cleared everything, reassess everything, and then only have an exit strategy.
It's beautifully done, Harsha. Good
sir,
job.
Sir,
we were watching you all the time.
Yeah, one important point. See this arterial pulsations. Are you able to appreciate?
Yes.
So
yes.
If there is an over dilatation, what the teachings, what we have learned from our teachers like Pal sir, always remain under, don't go over. So if there was an over dilatation in this case, I would have ruptured the renal artery here. It is exactly in front of my point of puncture, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Asha.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.